A few weeks ago, I got this light and sound device called NeuroVIZR that claims to induce a psychedelic effect and also improve your memory and learning in as little as 11 minutes per day of light stimulation. The geometric patterns and sound design were all really fun to experience, but I was skeptical if this device really had any real data or evidence behind it. I've noticed a bunch of these light and sound devices hitting the market lately, and it's confusing because we never really talked about devices like this in my medical school or military residency training to become a medical doctor. But after doing a deep dive, I found that there's a lot of evidence coming out of MIT that devices like this could actually be helpful for improving brain performance. So the market's naturally been flooded with similar devices looking to seize the opportunity while hopefully not giving you seizures as a result. In this video, we'll do a deep dive on my NeuroVIZR light and sound stimulation device experience, look at the scientific evidence behind the device, and compare it to similar devices that I've tried in the market to see if this would be a good fit for you or not. I really appreciate how simple this device is. You just take the light module and clip it onto the headband with a really satisfying magnetic clip that's quite strong. That light module isn't going anywhere when you wear it on your head. And then the design is very simple. There's just a power button and a USB port on the side of the light module. I like that the LED module isn't too heavy, which is a big plus in comfort factor when you're wearing this for long periods of time. If it was too heavy, it would weigh on the headband, which would get uncomfortable with time. The strap is just standard Velcro that goes around your head and adjusts for size. I was actually really impressed with the app. It's very modern and professional and clean. I found the Bluetooth pairing to the light pod to be just absolutely seamless. No issues there. One negative is I did find that the app struggled to download a few of the soundscapes when I was getting started out. So I did have to restart the app and then the soundscapes downloaded okay and it wasn't too big of an issue. They have over 100 different experiences on the app, way more than I could try in just a couple of weeks. So I'm really looking forward to trying even more of them over the coming months. Along with the brain optimizer and energizing sessions, they have experiences for better sleep, creativity, and even what they're calling drug-free microdosing. The Upbeat is the first track that I listened to. I loved the audio on this one, as well as the geometric patterns. And I'm not sure if it was the soundscape or just my excitement about working on this device and the script and the data that came with it. But after the session, I just immediately jumped into my workflow with a great flow state and got a ton of work done. On the second morning, I tried Peaceful Heart and I was just sitting there with so much gratitude that I almost literally cried. I was just thinking about my wife and my daughter, and I think it was the soundscape and the light stimulation, but I started to get really emotional. And afterwards, I actually had to lay down on the floor for about 5 minutes before getting started to work. It was a much different post-stimulation effect than I found on the Upbeat setting. I think on some of these exercises, it puts you into work mode, but on others, it just gives you like this workout. It's like, man, my brain's tired after all that stimulation. I need to take a 5 minute breather before I get back to work. It's really helpful that you can adjust the intensity of the light stimulation on the app. I don't personally like the lights to be too bright during these sessions or they wear me out and I get a headache. So toning it down a notch is really helpful. One thing that I did notice during these sessions is that it's easy for me to visualize if I want. Often before my meditation sessions, I'll journal my ideal future and then I'll go into my meditation session and visualize. But with this, I did the same thing, journaling, and then went into the NeuroVIZR exercise. And I noticed that all my visualizations were really bright and vivid. And I don't have a scientific explanation why it's easier to visualize when you're doing the NeuroVIZR sessions. But in my opinion, it's because it's activating your visual circuitry, which makes it easier to engage in those processes. I was just seeing my ideal future with so much clarity and brightness that it actually surprised me. Another negative thing that I noticed is that the battery life gets drained pretty quickly. It seemed like it would go down to 75% after just one session. And I'm sure it takes a ton of battery power to flash these lights at a given intensity. And they didn't want to pack a battery into the light module that was too heavy. Otherwise, it would be a comfort issue. So it's not too big of a deal. You get 4 or 5 sessions on one charge and then you can just charge it overnight and continue wearing it. Most of the sessions are about 11 minutes long, and I didn't have any neck strain from wearing the light device with the strap, no discomfort. I was also happy to find that you could actually run the light module without it being attached to the strap. That came in handy when I was recording my brainwave. I didn't want to mess up the EEG device by having another device strapped on top of it and worsen any movement data contamination. So I just put the light module on an iPad stand and it worked great. The light patterns of the NeuroVIZR are really fun. I'm excited to share them more with my friends and family. They're very mesmerizing and pretty. They did an amazing job with this, and I know that the founder has done a ton of research on how to make these patterns just totally engaging. I was seeing all kinds of geometric patterns and entering into these different mind spaces that I only usually see with meditation. There's a lot of different audio tracks. I really liked the one for upbeat. For the other ones, like Peaceful Heart, there's more traditional meditation music. I find that music to be boring, that's just me, but there's definitely a lot of binaural beat type influences with the audio as well. And I did try the sleep settings, and holy that thing totally knocked me out. Now, to make sure that it wasn't just my circadian rhythm that was affecting my sleep, I tried the go to sleep session during the day, and it made me almost literally fall asleep on the floor. That sleep experience, it's funny, it's kind of like an eerie vibe almost that like lulls you asleep. And the light patterns are slower. It's almost like a ceiling fan is kind of rotating and blocking light a little bit. That's what it felt like to me. I was laying in this eerie room with a ceiling fan on and some light was filtering in. And I just got super drowsy and falling asleep. I'm definitely going to find someone with insomnia and test this on them. They also have other settings for various parts of your day to set your circadian rhythm. There's a lot of evidence for light exposure in the early morning to set your circadian rhythm, as popularized by scientists like Dr. Andrew Huberman from Stanford. I'm definitely going to try to use the NeuroVIZR on some international travel that I have coming up soon, as well as during daylight savings to see if it resets my circadian rhythm quicker. I found the sleep setting to be very relaxing, and I definitely felt drowsy by the time I took it off. It was very easy to go to sleep afterwards. I might have to try using the NeuroVIZR in combination with the Muse headband in the future to see if it actually improved my sleep. So that's a rundown of what I actually felt from the NeuroVIZR, but let's dive into the science and see if this device could actually improve your brain health. The most exciting area of research right now for stroboscopic light stimulation comes out of MIT. In 2016, they found that if you stimulate rats visually by flashing lights at 40 oscillations per second or 40 hertz, it activates the immune system of the rat brain that actually starts to clear away beta amyloid plaques and other junk that accumulates in the brain over time and eventually leads to Alzheimer's disease. There's now even an MIT spinoff company called Cognito that actually has a device that is going through research for upcoming FDA clinical trials, and the early results have shown some benefits in humans to include better memory, completing daily tasks, and less confusion overall. Now, NeuroVIZR has not gone through similar studies, but it does have 40 hertz stimulation with other speeds of stimulation layered in so that it creates that geometric experience. So although we can't say that NeuroVIZR has the same effects, it does suggest that flashing light stroboscopic wearables may have an additional benefit to the human brain than just providing an entertaining light show. Now, I wanted to track some of this evidence for myself. There's currently no way that you can really track beta amyloid plaque in the human brain until, unfortunately, they've passed away and you do an autopsy. But there's a lot of evidence that the faster frequency EEG brainwaves, beta and gamma, decrease as someone develops Alzheimer's disease. So I thought, why don't I just track my brainwaves while I'm using the NeuroVIZR and see if the light stimulation increases my beta and gamma brainwave patterns. So I used a brainwave device called the Muse headband and was actually able to show that NeuroVIZR increased my beta and gamma brainwaves. Not only that, it did it during the session and there was a lingering effect afterwards as well. I was also able to show that the light stimulation increased the overall randomness of my brainwave signals with a special biometric measure called permutation entropy. Entropy is the randomness of a signal, and it's been known for several years that people that take psychedelics show an increased entropy both in their EEG brainwave patterns, but also brain blood flow patterns. It actually lines up pretty good that psychedelics sort of scramble your brainwave signals, because that's our conceptual understanding of them, right? It actually opens up the mind to be more flexible and allows people to perceive things outside of normal human consciousness, maybe think about things in different ways, which can be really healing in PTSD and depression. So it was actually really interesting to see that the NeuroVIZR created some similarities in brain patterns as psychedelics do, especially since NeuroVIZR actually advertised on their websites that there's a psychedelic microdosing effect. And now we know through this permutation entropy measurement that there's actually some validity to that statement according to the data. And it brings a little bit more credibility to their website where they're marketing these certain experiences as drug-free microdosing. So it's nice to see that these different light flickering stroboscopic devices that are hitting the market actually could have some benefit to people's brains over the long term, but with so many options, how do we choose which one is actually the right fit for you? One of the first light and sound devices that I used about 5 years ago was BrainTap by Dr. Patrick Porter. BrainTap has an LED visor and it actually has these headphones attached to it. So having the headphones could be an advantage over NeuroVIZR, where with NeuroVIZR, you actually have to use your own headphones or ear pods. But I actually don't like the earmuffs on BrainTap. They go right on your ear, which adds pressure and heat over time that makes my ears uncomfortable. So the version of BrainTap that I have, I don't actually find as comfortable as the NeuroVIZR. Another thing about BrainTap is that the flashing lights are more uniform. They pulse more uniformly. So you're not going to get all those really pretty geometric patterns that you get from the NeuroVIZR. And most of the audio tracks for BrainTap have this subliminal programming where Dr. Patrick Porter is talking. And I think it's really helpful for people that have low self-esteem and need some words of encouragement to try to learn and change their behavior or understanding of mental health.
Your eyes should be comfortably closed, and you're breathing now deep, rhythmic, and relaxed. With this relaxed, natural breathing process, notice with me now how energy itself follows thought. No two people sense, feel, or become aware of the relaxation response in the exact same way.
But honestly, I like the NeuroVIZR where I just get thrown into this musical adventure with this geometric light show. And with BrainTap, I feel like I'm just kind of having someone talk my ear off for 12 minutes at a time while I have these flashing lights try and change my brain state. I definitely think there's a brain state change with BrainTap, but I just don't like having to listen to someone talk for my whole experience. When I just have the music going and I see all those geometric patterns, I can just visualize my own goals and be more creative during the session, rather than it being more structured in the BrainTap experience. And last year I did a lot of work with Roxiva, which is a big, beautiful lamp with really high quality bulbs that creates these psychedelic patterns that I couldn't believe. It's a lot like NeuroVIZR, but the lights are more intense because of the brightness and the quality, and you can actually do group sessions with the Roxiva. But even though I loved the Roxiva experience when the light was on, there was a lot of negative experiences behind the scenes. In order to get the right settings on the Roxiva lamp, you have to navigate this analog screen on the back that was just a total pain. You had to go up and down and in the different files, no pictures, just all text. In comparison, the NeuroVIZR app was just a complete breeze. Also, you had to plug your headphones into the Roxiva lamp that was kind of far away. And with the Roxiva lamp, it's a big, heavy lamp and you have to mount it on something. Luckily, I have a film studio with a bunch of tripods so I could mount it on something like that, even to the point of needing a boom and a counterweight if you're gonna use it while you're laying down. But I just think that the average user that doesn't have a clinic doesn't have all that stuff. And the Roxiva was definitely stronger in light intensity, but that isn't always a good thing. I actually had to really often tone the intensity way down just because it's like uncomfortable to my eyes when it's that bright. So I could see the Roxiva being advantageous for like a clinic or group setting, but for the average user, I just think it's overkill. Because the NeuroVIZR produces these geometric patterns that are very similar to the Roxiva and definitely will get your money's worth, and the app is way easier to navigate and it's just easier to use overall for the individual user. And if that wasn't enough to make a decision, just take a look at the cost differences. NeuroVIZR is actually the cheapest option of the three light and sound devices that I've tried so far. I would say it definitely has the best value of experience versus cost, coming in at $500. BrainTap comes in at $907, and then you have to pay a $30 a month subscription fee after the first year. There's no subscription fee right now for NeuroVIZR. And how about that big, beautiful Roxiva lamp? That Roxiva lamp cost upwards of $5,000, which seems appropriate for a clinic in some cases, but for the individual user, seems quite a bit of overkill. So for $500 with the NeuroVIZR, you get a professional level light stimulation device. And I felt like the geometric patterns and soundscapes were very close to what you get for Roxiva for 1/10 the cost. Overall, I think that if you are worried about your memory or overall brain health, this device is worth a try. There's actually no pharmaceuticals on the market that can actually prevent Alzheimer's or improve your memory right now. I would say stay away from this device if you have a history of epilepsy or seizures. You don't want to induce one. But if you don't have a history of that, it should be really safe. I would say that it can be tiring to do these sessions, but your brain is actually getting a really good workout. I personally love how entertaining it is. It's a lot more fun actually than doing neurofeedback sessions. And I think that the literature on 40 hertz stroboscopic stimulation and prevention of Alzheimer's disease is massive. Now, the creators of NeuroVIZR were nice enough to give me a discount for the Techforpsych audience if you're interested in trying it out. There's an affiliate link below. It really helps support the channel. And if you want to see more in depth about how I used ChatGPT to analyze my brainwave data from the Muse headband while using NeuroVIZR to show increased beta and gamma waves and psychedelic effects, click this link here, and I'll see you on the other side.